Hi, and welcome to this CertMike Explains video. I'm Mike Chapple, a cybersecurity certification expert, and in each of these videos, I dive deep into a topic that often confuses people when they prepare for their exam and explain it in simple terms. In this video, I tackle a topic that started to show up in exams in the past year, homomorphic encryption. Now, this topic first showed up on the Security Plus SY0-601 exam objectives, and it has people a little worked up because it sounds very complicated, and it's a term that many people haven't seen before. Fortunately, there are a few basic facts that you'll need to know as you prepare for your next exam. Now, hopefully you already understand what encryption is and the role that it plays in a security program. If you don't, I have a whole separate CertMike Explains video covering encryption technology. Normally, we use encryption to protect the confidentiality of data. We have some secret information that we'd like to protect, and we encrypt it so that it is only readable by someone who has access to the correct decryption key. Imagine, for example, that I'm running an election, and I'd like to run a confidential electronic voting process. Each voter can create a file containing their vote, encrypt it using a key known only to me, and then send me their encrypted ballot. When I receive those ballots, I can decrypt them and then add up the votes to determine who won the election. That's a typical example of using encryption to provide confidentiality. Now, there is, however, an important limitation to the voting process that I just described. The ballot is confidential because it's encrypted. Anyone who intercepts a voter's message to me won't be able to identify who the person voted for because they don't have the decryption key. But for this approach to work, I have to have the decryption key, and that means that I know who each voter selected on their ballot. The ballots aren't secret because I know who everyone voted for. Now, in the offline world, we solve this problem by using secret ballots. When I go vote in an election, I show identification to prove that I'm a registered voter, and then the voting staff hands me a paper ballot that I go fill out privately. I make my selections on the ballot, but I don't write my name on the ballot. I then take it and deposit it in a box where it is later opened and counted, but the people counting the ballots don't know who cast each one, so they don't know who each voter voted for. They can only figure out the results of the election. Now, as you're probably guessing by now, homomorphic encryption provides an opportunity to solve this problem. Before I explain how homomorphic encryption works, I just want to take a moment to invite you to visit my website at certmike.com. On that site, I have free study plans put together to help you earn your next cybersecurity certification. The plans tie together the content that you'll find in study guides, video courses, and practice tests to help you prepare for your next certification exam and pass it on the first try. Also, if you're enjoying this CertMike Explains video, please take a moment to click the like button below to help other people discover it. If you subscribe to my channel, you'll be among the first to see my new cybersecurity videos as they come out. All right, let's now dive into how homomorphic encryption solves the voting issue that I mentioned earlier. Homomorphic encryption allows people to perform operations on encrypted data without actually decrypting the data. So in my voting example, I don't need to read all of the individual ballots to figure out who won the election. I can perform addition on the encrypted ballots without decrypting them. That gives me the results of the election without giving me the individual votes. Now, there are a few different types of homomorphic encryption that you need to know about. Additive homomorphic encryption allows me to perform the addition operation on encrypted data. That's what we'd use in my voting example. There's also multiplicative homomorphic encryption, which, you guessed it, allows you to multiply the results. And fully homomorphic encryption allows you to perform combinations of addition and multiplication on your encrypted data. There are a few implementations of homomorphic encryption out there today, but this is a technology that's still in its infancy. If you see an exam question on the topic, you'll just need to know the basic concepts that I covered in this video. The most important takeaway is remembering that homomorphic encryption allows you to perform mathematical calculations on encrypted data without decrypting the data itself. Homomorphic encryption can be an intimidating topic when you're preparing for a cybersecurity certification exam, but I hope that this video helped you understand it just a little bit better. If it did, please click the like button below and subscribe to my channel for more cybersecurity content.